This video is brought to you by Squarespace. Squarespace simplifies everything you need to create a stunning website, build, connect, and sell seamlessly all under your control. So we get a package from Huion. They sent me their Kamvas 13 pen display as well as the stand. They also sent their mini tablet, the H420. But unfortunately, the box got a little roughed up during the shipping. That's why you're not seeing it here. Well, let's jump right in and unbox the Kamvas 13 and the stand first. This video will cover all the features and specs of these products. I'll share my overall experience using them and give you some pros and cons at the end. As always, you'll get my honest thoughts and opinions in this review. So let's take a look at the Huion Kamvas 13 first. It comes with a bunch of nice features. There's actually multiple color selection of this, such as midnight green, purple, and I got the Cosmo Black. This pen display weighs 980 grams and comes with a 13.3-inch screen with a resolution of 1920 by 1080 pixels. It also comes with 8 customizable shortcut keys and an anti-glare film to reduce unwanted reflections. Actually, I initially thought the pre-installed anti-glare film was a temporary cover to be removed. Thankfully, I did some research and learned it's actually meant to stay on for reduced glare. So it also comes with a USB extension cable and a 3-in-1 USB cable, which are USB-C to USB power, USB connection, and HDMI for various connection options. Here's the artist glove, which helps to reduce friction while drawing. It feels smooth and comfy to wear. They've also included a cleaning cloth with the same texture used for cleaning and glasses. Last but not least, the PW517 pen. It's battery-free and boasts 8192 pressure sensitivity with Pentek 3.0 technology and supports a 60-degree tilt function. It is non-slip rubber, which I think it's comfy to hold. It even comes with a handy pen that doubles as a case for extra nibs. I was confused at first. I thought there's no additional nibs in the package, and I didn't know that the round object can actually open. I just discovered it later on. And here's the SD300. It can be adjusted between 20 and 60 degrees to suit your particular drawing style. There's a guide on how to use it, and there's like 6 to 7 viewing angles or position options. Now let's take a closer look at the Huion H420 graphic tablet. The pen itself is made of smooth, glossy plastic with a nice width to it. Also has a button on top. And then there's a USB cable and a card, and of course the tablet itself. It's incredibly small, just the same size of a hand, perfect for portability. The user manual has dedicated section for both Windows and Mac users, and even includes translated languages for wider accessibility. Before we proceed to the testing, let's talk about today's sponsor. Squarespace is a popular all-in-one platform designed to empower everyone, from beginners to established businesses, to build beautiful and functional websites. Whether you're an artist showcasing your art in online portfolio or a business owner setting up an online store, Squarespace provides all the tools you need to get started. You can choose from a wide variety of beautiful templates that suit your style. You can personalize it and truly make your website your own, just like I did with mine. And the Fluid Engine ties everything together. This drag and drop editor lets you personalize everything with ease. It is really smooth to edit and arrange everything. These days, a strong online presence is essential, and good thing Squarespace equips you with powerful SEO tools to ensure your website ranks high in search results. It helps your website get noticed organically by the right audience. Plus, you can optimize details like titles, descriptions, and page formats for maximum visibility. If this sounds interesting to you, then head to squarespace.com for a free trial, and when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/pateseich to save 10% off your first purchase of a website or a domain. A big thanks to Squarespace for sponsoring this video. Now on to the testing part. I just downloaded the Huion H420 driver and I'm adjusting some settings like pressure sensitivity. It seems accurate though. You can also customize the pen setting for a better experience. So the illustration software I'm using is Adobe Photoshop. Clip Studio Paint is definitely on my list to explore later on once I'm more comfortable with the basic tools. This tablet has actually been on my desk for weeks now. As I mentioned before, I was really intimidated, thinking digital art would be super hard to learn. But then from my previous video using a pen tablet, which was also my first time with digital art, I was surprised by the outcome. Having practiced traditional art fundamentals for years definitely made the transition to this medium smoother. So this Huion H420 works almost the same way as the graphic tablet that I've used before. It seems fine for digital drawing, but actually it's primarily designed for capturing signatures. Its compact size makes it ideal for signing documents on a computer screen. However, for someone just starting with digital art, this affordable option can be a great way to get used to drawing on a tablet before upgrading to a more professional graphic tablet, which basically means that if you have fun drawing with this one, it will only get better as you purchase better devices. Also, you can literally carry it in your pocket wherever you go. And since this tablet has very few moving parts, it seems durable and will withstand a few crashes against the ground without being seriously damaged. Also, it works with a phone. I tried it, no driver needed, but please take note, navigating the smaller screen can be a bit tricky. If you mostly work on the detailed pieces, the drawing area of this tablet might potentially slow down your workflow. You gotta have to use zooming tool like hundreds of times, and it's gonna be time consuming. Still, this tablet is perfect for quick sketches and ideas on the go. The only considerable disadvantage of this is the pen itself. It requires a separate AA battery. Still, this is a fully functioning drawing device that lets you draw nearly everywhere you go without hassle. If you buy this Huion H420 and you like it, great, you got a new device that will help you keep creating more artwork. Even if you don't use it all the time because you don't particularly like it, you still have a great drawing tablet for whenever inspiration strikes. You win either way. So I am picking the perfect reference for my niki drawing, and it took nearly 2 hours. I'm meticulous about lighting and angles, but I'm sure you guys can relate. Sketching will probably be quicker. So this 13-inch tablet offers two modes, the pen display, which is perfect for drawing directly on the screen, and the pen tablet mode, which really helps save power. Just connect it with a USB cable, no HDMI needed, or simply turn off the screen with a power button. The screen is fully laminated with up to 220 nits of brightness. They say it's quite low, but good enough for its price. It has this matte texture surface that not only helps reduce glare in bright conditions, but also delivers a decent level of friction and a nice paper feel while drawing. It's very satisfying. It is still replaceable as it will wear out after prolonged use. And the color accuracy or color gamut of this pen display delivers 120% sRGB with an 8-bit display, offers up to 16.7 million color recognitions, which makes your colors stand out. This Kamvas 13 is not a standalone tablet, so it needs to be connected to a computer, and when linked the two, you just require a 3-in-1 cable or USB-C cable for a less wired desk. The size of the pen display is actually perfect for my workspace or for anyone who has compact workspace. You can just easily readjust and maneuver in any position you want. Also, it fits in a standard laptop pouch, making it very convenient to carry. It's actually been almost 3 months since I got this Huion Kamvas 13. It is a separate package from H420. I received this early January, but only just started using it in March. I'm really grateful to Huion team for being so awesome and understanding. As you might remember from my last video, I was majorly hit with art block and feeling burnout, and I did manage to create some art and film a bunch of stuff, but it all just piled up in my storage like a massive backlog. I've only just started editing each of them, so some parts you'll see here was actually filmed last month. I just discovered that the pen is also compatible with almost all Huion Kamvas series drawing tablets, giving it a wide range of usage with other devices. Also, it supports Android, so it's possible to connect it to any Android devices, but not all Android devices support full screen mode on the Kamvas 13 display. You might need to enable desktop mode for Huawei phones or desk mode for Samsung phones for full functionality. So far, I'm having a great experience with this pen display. My art's already showing a jump in the quality compared to using a regular graphic tablet where I look at the monitor all the time while using a pen and a tablet with my hand, which does create a small degree of disconnect. Working directly on the screen makes a huge difference. I'm not an expert on pen display tablet because this is the first one with a screen that I've tried, but I think this Kamvas 13 is amazing for me. It looks great to draw on and the colors are pretty accurate. The laminated screen offers minimal parallax and great edge-to-edge accuracy. I've noticed a fair amount of pixelation though. Kinda a bit blurred on my laptop screen, so I guess I'll be searching later if I can still improve it or if there's something I needed to change in the setting. And I noticed this tablet gets hotter on the right side when I'm trying to use it for longer hours, so I think you should consider taking breaks every 3 to 4 hours or turning off the screen when not actively drawing. But the pen itself is awesome. It feels great in my hand. It's very lightweight. The pressure sensitivity seems on point. Plus, it doesn't need charging. The only thing to adjust to are the 2 buttons that I accidentally press sometimes. Maybe I'll get used to it after more practice. Since the screen is only 1080p and the pixel density is 166 ppi, I expect that it is a bit pixelated. The density of this tablet is lower than what you would get with a Kamvas Pro 13 2.5K model, but it's certainly enough for a 13-inch screen. The tablet does experience occasional lag when the right side gets hotter, but it recovers after a short break. Also, I've encountered some issue with the Huion driver. During extended drawing sessions, the buttons on the tablet occasionally stop responding, especially when I'm switching screens. It's quite inconvenient as I always rely on the buttons for quick shortcuts instead of keyboard commands. The driver sometimes displays a device disconnected message even though the cables are properly connected. A simple restart usually resolves the issue, but it disrupts my workflow and requires saving file of my drawing progress beforehand. Overall, for the price, the Huion Kamvas 13 is a great option for budget-minded artists who need a drawing tablet with a screen that has nice quality. It's got everything you need to get started. There are a couple of minor drawbacks, but you can invest in this pen display without breaking the bank to see if digital art is good fit for you in the long run. Plus, there's always room to upgrade for a better and bigger display if you love the experience. So we've explored 2 very different drawing tablets in this video. The choice ultimately boils down to your individual preferences, but if you are starting to try digital art on your phone, I suggest this Huion H420 graphic tablet since it's so affordable and easy to use, and it only costs around $24. Well, if you have a large screen or monitor, computer or laptop, and you crave a screen display experience, then the Huion Kamvas 13 is perfect for you. It is priced around $235, offers a great step up. As always, the links are in my description below. I also wrote a summary of pros and cons there. Thank you so much, Huion, for sending me these packages. I had so much fun trying them both out, even though it did take me weeks before I finally opened the boxes. Still so grateful for your kindness. But yeah, thanks again everyone for watching. I hope this honest review helped you guys decide which one could be good for you. See you in the next vid, bye!